this video, we're going to look at the basic principles which go into making a great informative video for customers when it comes to servicing. And the good news is, it's really, really simple. So, we've got the car up on the ramp with sufficient height for us to walk underneath. This is our starting position. First, we point the camera at the front registration plate and begin recording. We start by introducing ourselves, mentioning the customer's name, as well as our dealership. It's important to outline to the customer what we've done, i.e. a vehicle health check, and what we've found. For those vehicles where everything's okay, it's important to tell the customer the vehicle has a clean bill of health. Customers love good news. If there's work required on the vehicle, we begin by stating there are some items requiring attention, which we'd like to show you. Now the customer knows it's a video of their vehicle, who the presenter is, and its condition. Now we move underneath the vehicle to the passenger's front side, measuring the tyre. It's best to measure one tread line at the lowest point. To keep the video shorter, always remind the customer of the legal limit and the brand recommended limit before a change is required. This is 3 millimeters, with the legal limit being 1.6 millimeters. We should always ensure we measure the tread using a digital tire tread gauge. These are best to show on video as it's easy for the customer to read. Remember to use percentages to describe wear and tear, such as your tyres are 50% worn. This is a great way of keeping the terminology customer friendly, giving them an indication of remaining life. Now we measure the brake pads. In order to do this, we advise removing one wheel. We can measure either from the front of the disc or measure it from the inspection window, which is in the front of the caliper. When we're measuring both again, we need to be recording both measurements on the camera for transparency. It's worth noting that when showing the customer the wear on their brake pads, best practice would be to reference what the pads are when new. We can then draw into the shot the actual pad measurement as they stand now. This is a simple and helpful visual aid, which shows the customer exactly how much the pads are worn. Moving on to disc thickness, we need to measure one disc per axle set before giving the customer the measurement. We also need to explain to them the condition of the disc, whether it be lipped, scored, cracked, or corroded. At this point, it's always helpful to explain to the customer the minimum discard thickness. This way, they'll know how close the disc is to needing replacing. We would repeat the process on the front driver's side, checking the tyres and brakes. We've now gone past the first stage of walking, talking, and recording. It's all plain sailing from here on in. While we're under the vehicle, we should show the sump, gearbox, drive shaft, and suspension. At this point, if necessary, we can highlight to the customer anything that might be an issue. If there's a leak somewhere, for example, this can be pointed out. Anything that needs attention can be highlighted using a laser pointer. This helps the customer to understand more about their vehicle and where some of these components are located. As we continue to go through, we check the exhaust to make sure it's all secure and there's no damage. We also need to check the brake and fuel lines. It's always worth explaining to the customer what these are and that they're okay. When we reach the back of the vehicle, we'll check the rear box again to make sure it's secure and there's no damage or corrosion. Once we've done that, we move to the offside rear to check the tyres, brakes, and suspension. And you'll probably have noticed that what we're doing is exactly the same as what we do on a day-to-day basis, but with a camera. We don't want to make things complicated, so the tyres, brake pads, and rear discs will be measured the same way the front ones are. If there are any issues with them, we'd highlight this to the customer and explain that this is the reason they need to be replaced. Again, complete transparency. And that's pretty much it. We'd finish the video as we started it, but this time at the rear of the car and displaying the rear number plate. We provide some next steps, which ensure that the customer knows exactly what's going to happen with a call to action. This will usually be a service advisor contacting them shortly. It's always important to summarise the work if there is any required on the vehicle. We should also mention that a quotation to conduct the work or replace parts will be attached to the video. We thank them for choosing our dealership and also for watching the video. This allows us to recognise that the customer has a choice. It also encourages loyalty and retention. And we've created a really simple, straightforward, but important video for the customer. Remember, we need to ask the customer to rate the video. Not only does this help to improve what we're doing, it also shows them that we care about their feedback. In turn, this demonstrates to the customer that they're an integral part of service improvement. Thank you very much for watching.